Hi guys, welcome back. I'm Tiffany Watches and New Subbies. Welcome to my channel. So today we're going to show you how to apply the soft gel method. And we are going to be using our Madam Glam. I absolutely love this. We are going to be using this Grassy Sassy. It is very, very opaque. You only need one coat and you should be good to go. So we're going to go ahead and start by pushing back our cuticles. I'm going to use this as a rest stand. So first off, you're going to push back your cuticles. Let me see. And as y'all can tell, my cuticles are really, really grown out. So make sure you push them back. That's a nail polish. I haven't done this in a long time, and we have a little bit of growth in our cuticles on our nail plate, and it's pretty bad. Next, you can go in with your sanding band, or whatever you like to prep your nail with. Usually, I like to go on with a sanding band. Sorry, I'm sniffling, I have allergies. I usually get them really bad in the morning and at night. But today I'm going to be going in with a diamond bit. You're also going to be etching the nail with this. Usually, like I said, I usually go in with a 180 grit sanding band. Remove the dead skin off the nail plate. And you can even go around your epinicium. Alright, so we already did that. We're going to go ahead and clean them. And we are using our swipe. Okay, now we are going to etch the bottom of, or the underneath of the nail tip. I forgot to mention, I did already size them. So you do have to size them and make sure they fit sidewall to sidewall. Sometimes I like to go a tiny bit where they're a little bit bigger than my nail. Just because when you do put gel polish or anything, they do shrivel up a little bit. Okay, so there, sounds good enough. And we're also going to file the cuticle area. We are going to go over the top two, but for now, we'll do that. Whoops, there goes my nail. The cuticle area a little bit. We're going to go ahead and clean this. The nail tip off. Dust it off. Now I'm going to go back in and remove any dust that I have on there. And again, I'm using my Young Nails swipe. And seriously, the best. Now, this part you don't have to do. A lot of people don't do it. I like to do it. just because my, I don't know, I have really oily nails, and I get oil grow super fast, so it helps with the adherence, or so I like to believe. So some people will say differently, that it makes it where they don't last long, but to me, they work. It works. 1 second. Alright, now we're going to be applying our 6-in-1 nail glue gel, and I am using the gel-like AC. That's the one that I use. I do have the model ones. Is it the model ones? Or the beetle one? The beetles? Beetle and... But I just go to this one first because I did have this one first and I want to finish it up. We're going to apply a coat to my nails. If you do get on your skin, make sure you wipe it off because you don't want to cause any allergic reactions. Okay, so there is that. We're going to go ahead and cure. Okay, so it's already cured. We are going to start. I like to start off from starting with my pinky and move on inwards towards my thumb. So we're going to start off with the ring finger. And we're going to apply a thin coat to the nail bed area. And then we're going to remove the excess from the nail brush onto the gel brush onto the cuticle area. Now we are going to, so I like to use that little goose lamp, a gooseneck, whatever it's called, just because it's a lot easier for me. We are going to, sorry, let me move this first really fast. We're going to apply it at an angle. I like to go in just slightly and near the cuticle area and then slide it downwards, if that makes sense. And again, we're going to start off at a cuticle area, slanted, start about right there, and then slide it in. I don't think you're going to be able to see with the lamp, but we're going to try to show you. Start off there, glue it, set it down, and there we go. You always want to try to avoid any air bubbles because that can cause lifting, and you can also get mold under there, and obviously we don't want that. So once I cured on that lamp, the flash curing lamp, I'm going to go and set my hand in the other lamp. I just like to be safe and make sure I cure it a little bit longer. Again, I have really oily nail beds and a lot of cuticle growth. Okay, let me show you. There is absolutely no air pockets. Now this hand, I did my finger, it's like going slanted, so I'm not going to show you. But we're going to show you again really fast. So, excuse me. We're going to apply a thin layer first, where the cuticle area is at. Where the nail bed. And then apply the excess of the cuticle area. Again, you're going to apply it around near the cuticle area and slide it in, but at an angle as well. So here we go. So apply it at an angle first near the cuticle and slide it in. Now air pockets, we're going to go. We're good to cure. And again, I only cure it for a little bit. on the gooseneck lamp. And then I go into my regular lamp and cure once again. Alright, so now once they're on, we're going to go ahead and trim them to the desired length. I like to measure with this. So. And I leave it a little bit extra long because we do have to file. This one's a little bit too long. Gonna go in and file strip. Alright, now we're going to find all the lateral signs. Make sure they're flush. Now we're gonna go in with our sanding band and go over the top while I rough it up the tip. You wanna rough it up because they are very smooth. And if you don't rough it up, the gel polish won't stick to it that well. Dust it off. And once again, we're going to go in with our swipe. For the base, I'm going to go with I'm Blushing by Idol Beauty. That's the color. Alright, I did go on my skin, so we gotta make sure we clean that up. Wipe the lateral sides and the tip. And then cure it. Okay, now we're gonna go in with our Madam Glam. There's a little bit of blotching here, though, like it puddled there. We're gonna go ahead and leave it like that. So I'm going with our Madam Glam. A Sassy Green. I do have a discount code that will be listed down below. Oops. Okay, this one's puddling. Okay, I like to go in at the tip and the sides a little. And then form my French right after that. And you're going to be using some glitter, so let's get that in hand. I like to look at it from all angles. I look at it from this side and from this side. Now I do have it on my skin, so I do have to go clean it up a little bit. But we can do that right now. In just a second. That looks about right. I usually go with a brush, but we're going to use our wooden stick now to make sure we clean off any extra polish. Okay, now we're going to go in. I forgot you are supposed to go in before adding your front with your top coat because I'm going to be doing a sugar effect, so I should have done that first, but it's alright. No worries, let me find that little spoon. 1 second, I don't know where I left it. Alright, well I have no idea where it's at, so we're going to use a nail tip. I am so clumsy. Tap off the excess. And I'm missing a whole spot right there. That's freaking amazing. I'm telling you guys, I am so clumsy. I grab a little bit more polish. Pop that right there. Add some more glitter. Tap the excess off. Okay, now before curing, I do like to rub my fingers through the lateral sides and the free edge, just to make sure that it's not sticking out or it's not seeping out. There it is. We're going to go ahead and cure. It's done. And we're going to dust off the remaining glitter that's on the nail bed. There's a piece of bristle. There it is. So, like I said, you usually want to add your top coat first, but we didn't, so we have to go in. And carefully go around that punch. Alright, now we're going to go ahead and cure. Alright, now we're going to apply actually, I think we're going to add some pearls. Let me see. They're too plain for me. Let me see, one sec. I think we're going to add some pearls to this now. And we're going to be using a Mercart rhinestone glue. We're going to add a huge pearl. And these are rhinestones, they're not crystals. Usually for me, because I am very rough with my nails, I only do a rhinestone. Sometimes I will do crystals, not today. Let me put this back. We might add some tiny, tiny pearls. Oops. Okay. think we're gonna go ahead and leave it like that. I am going to remove the excess glue. And we're going to cure. Wipe the crystals one more time before we go. Sorry, rhinestones. And last but not least, we're going to apply our cuticle oil. Oh my goodness, it's so late. It's 11 o'clock. I need to get myself to sleep. Rub it in. And that is it for now, guys. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys till the next time. Again, I will be leaving my discount code in the description box for a discount with Madam Glam. They are amazing. I love their polishes. Very opaque. You only need one coat and it saves you money. So, again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys until next time. Bye.